work together to strengthen us spiritually as individuals and in our homes. After God created all things, he rested on the seventh day and commanded that one day each week be a time of rest to help people remember him. The Sabbath is God's time, a sacred time specifically set apart for worshiping him and for receiving and remembering his great and precious promises. The Lord has directed in this dispensation that thou mayest more fully keep thyself unspotted from the world. Thou shalt go to the house of prayer and offer up thy sacraments upon my holy day. And unto you to rest from your labors and to pay thy devotions unto the Most High. Thus on the Sabbath we worship the Father in the name of the Son. By participating in what we can, look to God and live. By receiving and remembering the great and precious promises whereby we become partakers of the divine nature. The Lord always has commanded his people to build temples, holy places in which worthy saints perform sacred gospel ceremonies and ordinances for themselves and for the dead. Temples are the most holy of all places of worship, the house of the Lord, a sacred space specifically set apart for worshiping God and for receiving and remembering his great and precious promises. The Lord has directed in this dispensation, organize yourselves, prepare every needful thing, and establish a house, even a house of prayer, a house of glory, a house of order, a house of God. The principal focus of temple worship is participating in ordinances and learning about receiving and remembering covenants. We think, act, and dress differently in the spaces that we may frequent. A principal purpose of the temple is to elevate our vision from the things of the world to the blessings of eternity. Removed for a short time from the worldly settings with which we are familiar, great and precious.
Should I talk now?
Okay, I'm ready.
As instituted by God,
the purposes
of these two divine sources of help are exactly the same. To powerfully and repeatedly focus our attention upon our Heavenly Father, his only begotten Son, the Holy Ghost, and the promises associated with the word should be the ultimate combination of time and space wherein individuals and families remember most effectively God's great and precious promises. Leaving our homes to spend time in Sunday meetings,
Well, that was a good shot. Okay.
In response to their faith and silent prayers, the Lord responded, "Be of good comfort. I will ease the burdens which are put upon your shoulders, that even you cannot feel them upon your backs." So now,
Okay. Wait. Don't. Okay. Are you ready to shoot?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go.
Ultimately, so great was their faith in their patience that Alma and his people were delivered by the Lord, as will be.
Oh, we got it. Good job.
Hey, Dickon.